this pipeline also in a non-physiological case, so in pathological condition.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Hey,
thank you very much again to Roberto. We pass to the next speaker, that is Simone Stella, also from our group. Hi, Simone.
Hi, Marco. I can hear you.
So Simone, despite today is not talking about clinical applications, Simone is one of us that is more in strict collaboration with clinics. So you need to tell them fast answer. And so it's also for this, he is now investigating a way to speed up electromechanical models. And so the talk of today is focused on this topic by using the Aconal problem instead of the monodomain or bidomain equation. So please, Simone, thank you.
Thank you, Marco, for your presentation, and good evening, good afternoon, and good morning to everyone. The work I'm going to present is about a fast cardiac electromechanics model based on the Aconal problem. This work is in collaboration with Francesco Regazzoni, Christian Vergara, Luca Dede, and Alfio Quarteroni. Okay, so I want to start briefly saying that, okay, about cardiac electromechanics, computational cardiac electromechanics, which nowadays play a fundamental role in some aspects. For example, improving the knowledge of the heart function and dysfunction to provide responses in a quantitative way, in a non-invasive way, in terms of mechanical outputs, mechanical biomarkers, and to support clinicians in the preventions, in the decisions, in the diagnosis and treatment of pathologies. But what is the problem? When we want to compute with numerical simulations the cardiac electromechanics, we have to face with some issues in terms specifically of computational costs. Specifically, the electrophysiology part requires spatial and temporal discretizations fine enough to accurately capture the phenomenon. So this part makes the full electromechanical model problem very computational onerous. So the idea was to have an electromechanical model to reduce these computational costs, starting from the idea of the reaction Aconal model for the electrophysiology part. The idea is to couple the Aconal model with the mechanical activation, so with the mechanical part of the model, with an offline reaction model. So to recover the calcium concentration at the cost of the Aconal problem solution, which is almost real time. Why we want to recover the calcium concentration? Because we need this concentration to activate the mechanical part of the model. This is the general pipeline of the model. So we start from at the top, we have the electrophysiology part. So we have the classical Aconal model, which gives the activation time to this that we call reaction model, the reaction offline model, which gives the calcium concentration to the temporal loop part, the mechanical part, coupled with a 0D circulation model. And now I want to go in details of all these models, starting from the Aconal model. We use the Aconal diffusion model, the classical Aconal diffusion model, in which the unknown is the activation time of the ventricle. Then we move to the reaction model. As I said, we started from the idea of the reaction Aconal model, which is to solve this simplified version of the monodomain model, which is the monodomain model without the diffusion part, with a suitable applied current. But the idea is to solve this similar 0D unsteady offline problem. I call it offline because we want to solve this problem once and for all with a suitable applied current. And so from solving this offline 0D unsteady problem, we can recover the unknowns of the 3D reaction Aconal problem, depending on the Aconal solution. So we have to switch in time the all the solutions of this 0D problem to recover the full solution, gating variables and action potential. But specifically, we want to focus on the calcium concentration. So depending on the chosen ionic model, we are able to compute the calcium concentration in all the ventricle and for all the time steps that we need for our simulations. I want to highlight that the all AP part, so the aconal model plus the reaction model, has the same computational cost of the aconal model. Then we need to connect this electrophysiology part with mechanical activation. And for the mechanical activation, we use the physics-based active force model, Regazzoni De Quarteroni 2020. So this model is a model based on a representation of the proteins in the sarcomeres. It is a physics-based model, but MF stands for mean field, so it's a model which has a lower computational cost with respect to richer physics-based models. This model gives as a solution the state variable, which gives us the permissivity and allows us to compute the active tension. Active tension, which is needed by the active and passive mechanics model, the classical model, starting from the momentum conservation equation and with the Piola-Kirchhoff stress tensor, in which we have the active part, with the active mechanics, the active part, which is modeled by the active stress, and the passive part, which is modeled by the Guccione law. Then we need to recover the sarcomere length, which is an input for the active force generation model, the RDQ 2020 model, which is determined starting from the sarcomere length at rest and by solving this simple OD system. Then we couple all the mechanical part with a 0D blood circulation model, specifically two element afterload Wien-Kessel model. And finally, we close all the system with the following relation, which connect the 3D part, which allows us to compute the volume in the left ventricle, which is an input for the 3D mechanic model. So recalling all the aconal reaction mechanics model, we have the first part of the electrophysiology part, which is the aconal diffusion model. Then we have the reaction model, which is a 0D offline model. So we solve it once for all for a chosen ionic model. Then we have the mechanical activation, the Regazzoni De Quarteroni 2020 activation model. Then the active and passive mechanics and the sarcomere length computation. And finally, 0D blood circulation, two element Wien-Kessel afterload model. Comparing just briefly, I want to compare this aconal reaction mechanics model with a classical electromechanical model with mono or bidomain model. We have, for example, that for the classical EM model, we need a fine spatial scale for electrophysiology and for mechanical activation models. In our case, we need a coarse spatial scale because we have at disposal the aconal model. For the classical electromechanic model, of course, we have high accuracy for the electrophysiology part thanks to the fine spatial scales. In our case, we have a lower accuracy for the electrophysiology part, but we have, of course, lower computational costs. Instead, in the classical electromechanical model, we have very, very high computational costs. Finally, we need for the classical electromechanical model a fine DT, a fine spatial discretization for the electrophysiology for the activation models. In our case, we don't need a spatial temporal discretization because we have a steady aconal problem plus an offline reaction problem. And I want to underline that both models requires the same spatial case for active and passive mechanics. So for the active and passive part, we have almost the same configuration. About the numerical approximation of the model, we have the time discretization. So we discretize with the backward differentiation formula of order one the all evolutionary problems. The Econal problem is solved with a pseudo-time formulation, and the reaction problem is discretized in time with a backward differentiation formula of order one and an implicit-explicit scheme for the ionic current. About the space discretization, we use continuous finite elements of order one on hexahedral elements with a GMRS with a AMG preconditioner for all resulting linear systems of the full model. Here, I want to briefly describe the algorithm to solve the ERM model. So we start to solve the Econal diffusion model with a given activation time. Then, once solved the offline reaction model, we import the calcium concentration and we switch in time depending on the solution of the Econal problem. We compute the initial displacement and then we go inside the temporal loop. We start with the computation of the sarcomere length. Then we enter in the second in temporal loop, which is the temporal loop composed by the substeps of the activation model. So we interpolate in time the calcium concentration we give in to the active active mechanical model, which allows us to compute the active tension. Then we go back inside the whole temporal loop, computing the pressure from the 0D Wien-Kessel afterload circulation model. And then we finally compute the new displacement in the active and passive mechanics. So some novelties, as I said, are an efficient way to solve the reaction problem completely offline and not at each time step. A physics-based active force model for the mechanical activation. Then we couple the 3D problem with the Wien-Kessel model for the blood circulation. And finally, we want to focus on analyzing numerical results, aiming at assessing the validity of the method in reproducing significant mechanical biomarkers such as PV loops, ejection fraction, and diastolic volume, and so on. About numerical results, we started stimulating the left zygote ventricle with a 3-point stimulation, able to surrogate the Purkinje network in the left ventricle. We choose the delay in time between the stimuli in order to reproduce the conduction velocity in the Purkinje network. Some data that we use in our simulation, we use the Bayer-Blake-Planck-Trajanova algorithm for the fiber generation, the Tentascher-Panfilov ionic model for the reaction problem. We performed 1,000 cardiac cycles for the offline computation of the calcium concentration to reach the limited cycles, which takes a few seconds of simulations, which is a 0D problem. And then we performed 5 cardiac mechanical cycles, and we found that the limit cycle values are reached in the second heartbeat thanks to the use of the Wien-Kessel model for the 0D circulation. And finally, just the values of the space and time discretizations. Okay, so we started with a classical 3-point stimulation, and in this slide I show that performing 5 cycles, just in the second cycle we reach the limit cycle, we are able to capture the final configuration of all variables, PV loops, calcium concentration, sarcomere length, and so on. So we started to vary some parameters and see how the model reacts to these variations and if the model is able to reproduce different kind of scenarios changing parameters. So we started analyzing how the model reacts to these variations. So for example, we increased the total peripheral resistance and we have an increasing in the PV loop area, then we increase the end diastolic volume, for example, or we reduce the contractility in the activation model, or we increase the total peripheral resistance and both total peripheral resistance and end diastolic volume. But we also investigated another scenario, a pathological one, including an idealized scar, so a portion of the left ventricle with a zero conductivity. In the specific case, we used a sphere intersected with the left ventricle. So in this area, we have zero conductivity, and we found that the model is able to reproduce a good PV loop also in this case with a zero conduction velocity for a specific part of the left ventricle. So the idea is to move to deeply study and analyze this aconal reaction model and compare the numerical results with the electromechanical model using the bidomain model in terms of accuracy and computational time. Then we want to introduce patient-specific geometric and electrical data and evaluate, as I said, mechanical biomarkers with respect to clinical ones. Finally, we want to go in the clinical context in collaboration with the Ospedale di Rovereto, Santa Maria del Carmine. We want to evaluate the influence of the compliance on the CRT procedure, cardiac resynchronization therapy. And so we want to evaluate the ejection fraction DPDT with the goal to explore different scenarios in these clinical cases. So different scenarios means different location for pacing size and different choose for delay in time to reduce the non-responder rate, the clinical invasive procedure, and the radiation to exposition. Thank you everyone for your attention. I finished.
Oh, thank you very much, Simone. Any question from the audience, please? For Simone? Okay, I see one raise hand, please. Elias?
Hi, thanks for the nice talk. Just, I didn't quite get completely this offline simulation. Could you just briefly explain that again? So you solve that as a 0D for once and for all?
Okay, wait, I'm going back to the, okay, to this part, let's say.
Okay.
Okay, the idea is that starting from the monodomain model without the diffusion part, the 3D monodomain model, if we change variables in the sense that we have this T tilde equal to the classical time minus the solution of the aconal problem, we have this new model, which is just depending in time, so it's 0D in space. We have no space dependency, except for the dependency on the activation time. So we can solve this model just for one chosen time. So we have the shape of the solution. If we want to focus on the calcium concentration, we have the shape of the solution of the calcium concentration of the Tentascher Pamphilov ionic model. And then we move this shape depending on the solution of the activation model. So depending on if we focus on a degrees of freedom, depending on in which time these degrees of freedom activates, we move this calcium concentration. Oh. So we are able to reproduce the calcium concentration spreading in all the myocardium, just starting from this acquired offline solution, let's say.
Okay, yeah. Thank you, now I got it, thanks.
Thanks to you.
Okay, so thank you very much. There are other questions?
Yeah, just one real quick. How did you decide to use the Tentascher model?
So your question is why we chose the Tentascher ionic model and not other? But this is our starting idea. So this model allows to use all ionic model that we have at disposal, that we have implemented. So this is just a choice, because being an offline problem, we can solve this 0D problem with the Tentacher Panfilo. So now we have the solution of the 0D problem of the Tentacher Panfilo, but we have also at disposal the 0D solution of all other ionic models. This is just a choice.
Okay, and when you fully solve the model, this isn't stochastic, right? So you get to store all of the solutions, then you can just kind of look them up.
Sorry, I can't hear you good. Can you repeat your question?
Yeah, sorry. Say it a little bit differently. When you want to implement the Tentacher model, to kind of get, or at least what I'm understanding is that you are running the Tentacher model and then storing all of its outputs because it's not stochastic, so that then you can look those up without having to calculate them each time?
No. The idea is to run this 0D model when choosing the ionic model, for example, the Tentacher Panfilo. So we run 1,000 cardiac cycles, and we take the last cardiac cycle, so when we reach the limit cycle, and we take the solution of this last cardiac cycle. And this is the solution of the action potential and all gating variables of the Tentacher Panfilo. So we store the solution, and we have these solutions at disposal to take in the model in the old pipeline that I showed. I don't know if I answered your question.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks to you.
Okay, thank you everybody. So I'd like to thank you to the speaker and to Professor Natalia Trajanova to have the opportunity to have a virtual coffee with her. Now it's time to close this breakout room and